Coming soon to theaters.
Hello, Wendy.
My apologies, miss.
Curses! Bring her down! Punish me!
Hey! I'm her daughter, Jane!
Oh, come on now, don't fuss.
Curse off!
I've got a little surprise for you, Peter Pan.
Coming soon to own on video and DVD.
Interrupt this broadcast for a special weather bulletin. The snow continues to fall. All schools, all stores, all roads will be closed until further notice. In other words, we're snowed in.
What? Oh, no!
Gosh, Mickey, if we're snowed in, how are we supposed to get home to our families?
Aw, don't worry, fellas. You've got family right here, all of us.
I always wanted a duck for a brother.
Join Mickey Mouse and all your favorite Disney friends in a full-length animated movie, Mickey's Magical Christmas, snowed in at the House of Mouse. New to video and Disney DVD, November 6th.
It was the moment that changed her life forever, taking her to a place she'd never been, to a life she dared only dream about. Discover what comes after Happily Ever After as Walt Disney's most enchanting fairy tale continues. Cinderella 2, Dreams Come True. The life of an ordinary girl becomes extraordinary in an all-new full-length adventure.
I have to try this my way.
Featuring your favorite characters from one of Disney's greatest treasures, Cinderella.
Maybe it's time to start following your heart.
Now this is more like it.
And a new rendition of the Oscar-nominated classic, Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo, together with three brand new songs. The magic lives on.
Someday I'll get this princess thing right.
I think that day is today.
Cinderella 2, Dreams Come True. Premiering only on Disney DVD and video, February 2002. return to all the wonder and majesty of Disney's classic masterpiece as the story continues in an all-new animated movie, The Hunchback of Notre Dame 2, featuring the returning all-star voice talent of Demi Moore, Kevin Kline, Tom Hulce, and introducing Haley Joel Osment as Zephyr and Jennifer Love Hewitt as Quasimodo's new friend, Madeline.
She's never seen anybody quite like him before.
It didn't start this way.
I play Madeline in the movie. She's very insecure and doesn't particularly feel pretty or confident or anything like that. And he thinks she's beautiful and amazing.
Maybe someone could love me.
I was lost, but now I'm found. His happiness around.
He sort of inspires her to be a better person. And it's a really amazing story, and it's one of the best love stories you could ever see.
Walt Disney Pictures proudly presents a movie that shows miracles do happen. And true love can come true.
I think it's going to be a fantastic movie. I think it's going to be something that you want to have in your house so that you can watch it over and over again. It's a really sweet story.
Thank you.
The Hunchback of Notre Dame 2. Premiering only on video and Disney DVD. Spring 2002. Classic tradition of Disney family entertainment comes an all-new adventure.
Hi. Hello.
It's the story of a young elephant lost in the wild.
Just say you'll help me find my mother.
And his courageous journey to find his way home. Featuring the voice talents of Joan Rivers, Betty White, and Angela Bassett. Whispers, An Elephant's Tale.
I promise I'd always take care of you.
Now available to own on video and Disney DVD. Coming soon to video and DVD, Walt Disney Pictures presents
Peter Pan,
the special edition of the original masterpiece, where pixie dust began and the adventure took flight.
How do we get to Neverland?
Fly, of course.
Say your prayers, huh? I'll get you for this plan.
The timeless story of a boy who never grows up and a magical journey to a land where dreams come true.
Oh, Peter, you saved my life.
The special edition of the original Peter Pan. Coming soon for a new generation to own on video and Disney DVD. Premiering July 17th, a whole new adventure awaits inside the Book of Pooh.
Look!
When Christopher Robin is away, Pooh and his pals come out to play.
Oh, I can't wait to hear a story.
It's a tale of fun, as everyone plans a very special surprise for Eeyore.
So you can see why I'm quite excited.
It's the all-new full-length adventure your whole family is sure to love.
A great adventure.
Jump into The Book of Pooh, premiering only on video and Disney DVD July 17th.
When you wish
This was the world of Walt Disney. From here, he reached out to touch us with his spirit, inspire us with his imagination, excite and entertain us with his vision. Now, in the year he would have celebrated his 100th birthday, Walt Disney's spirit continues to captivate us. His legacy endures in a very special collection. I'm proud to be your host for Walt Disney Treasures.
An all-new collection of four limited editions, each individually numbered. Enjoy the fun-filled antics of Silly Symphonies and Mickey Mouse in living color. Take a nostalgic tour of Disneyland USA and journey into the wilderness with legendary frontiersman Davy Crockett.
Let Walt Disney share his vision and his greatest treasures with you.
Walt Disney Treasures, coming exclusively to Disney DVD.
Disney's Gold Classic Collection on video and Disney DVD.
This is gonna be fun.
We got to all stay together, good friends.
We'll always be friends forever.
Disney's Gold Classic Collection. Movies that bring your family together. Look for all these great family films on video and Disney DVD.
Yeah! To infinity and beyond!
This card's for a celebration!
Imagination for a lifetime.
Shows and movies, we totally forget we are stuck in the middle of nowhere. So if you're ever stranded on an island or just in your living room, ask your mom or dad to call your local cable company.
Hello.
And tell them you can't survive without Toon Disney, the all-toon channel made just for kids.
To me, it's a movie that's got everything.
If you ask people who they love Mickey Mouse and, you know, Minnie Mouse, right? And they immediately go...
Dumbo was put into production very quickly and apparently moved through production more easily and with greater speed than I think any other Disney animated feature.
Because the story was simple, the crew was very small, with that kind of a setup, it's easy to get into a flow.
The animation streamed out of their fingertips like lightning onto the paper because the idea was so clear and simple.
But it feels like everybody was having fun and just enjoying themselves in the sense that it wasn't trying to sort of break through and be the Citizen Kane of animation. The animators could just sort of enjoy what they were doing.
My memory of it is that it just appeared there all of a sudden. You know, I was not conscious of people working on it as I was with all the other early films, Fantasia and Pinocchio and Bambi, and of course Snow White.
And in the middle of all that is this nice, sweet, little candy-colored Dumbo. And I think it gets taken for granted.
You don't think about it when you're looking at it, but it is only 60 minutes long. And movies aren't supposed to be 60 minutes long, you know. It's just odd length in a lot of ways. But it doesn't want to be any longer than 60 minutes.
It is not pretentious. It is not over. It is so entertaining, with a capital E, and represents so many of the Disney values we've kind of grown to love and accept.
And fortunately, because it wasn't an enormously expensive picture, and that it was relatively short, it made money.
When it was released, the Potasia, Walt wanted them to try it out. He wanted to lead them on a different path. But what they wanted, I think, was something...
Not a movie that looks like Snow White did or Bambi did. It's not very complicated to look at.
If you look at the backgrounds, they're very, very loose. They're almost gestural, some of them. Those tents, those big tents, I mean, they're just a wash of color, basically.
It's just real big, simple, and the music sort of carries you along, and boy, you get right into this thing where Dumbo is the outcast.
How many kids grow up feeling you identify with that little character? And I think every kid at some point has to feel that.
You can layer all your emotions on him because he can't speak for you. And somehow when...
It can be such a beautiful little film and your main character doesn't say one word.
Dumbo does not speak throughout the whole film. And this is quite a challenge to the animator who did it.
You know, that is such a non-dialogue beginning.
I can relate to him more because he doesn't say a word in the story.
That's really good animation.
And then for him to find Timothy Mouse, obviously, who...
When Timothy comes in and says, and you really wish you had, you know, somebody to come up and take care of those bullies for you.
He's just your ultimate buddy. It makes for a terrific contrast.
Just really appreciate the ones that are protecting him. Mrs. Jumbo really kicks it, you know, because she's protecting little Dumbo, probably even more naive and innocent than Bambi in some ways.
He has one of the most beautiful trains in it that were ever animated.
One shot of it coming into town when it introducing...
Boy, that map of Florida and the little railroad train and you know, that whole Americana, the circus is coming to town kind of a thing, which, although the circus is a European invention, we sort of, the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey kind of adopted it and me Americanized it.
Well, to me, it's a very uplifting
story. Get to an historical perspective because the circus to us now, today, sitting here in the new millennium, is kind of a romantic notion.
All-time sweetest scene in the world.
It is absolutely amazing of how you feel for those two at that time.
One of the absolute best moments in animated history.
I really want to go home and be cradled by somebody.
To me, it's a movie that's got everything. Heart, imagination, humor, great characters, wonderful songs, and that eye-popping...
Zorro world.
Anything goes.
It's truly an inspired sequence.
You know, there's a section in there where it's weird.
It's bizarre, you know. I love the thinking on it. To go, I just love the idea of that. It turns into such a lovely moment.
I think it's a near contrast to all the sadness going on, because
you try and find me another piece of animation as
is the pink elephant sequence. I want to see it because I still have it. I think it is one of the greatest sequences ever put on film by anybody anywhere.
Well, Ward Kimball animated the crow sequence and their dance, When I See an Elephant Fly. And he had a...
study that animation because it's something that I can't do. Like, a nice change in their character development as well, because they're kind of nasty and mean at the beginning, but Timothy is able to...
The whole thing about the magic feather doesn't show up until almost at the end.
He triumphs in the end, and he can fly, and he's the star of the show. You triumph somehow.
Believe in yourself.
It is probably the simplest Disney story for a feature ever.
That's Dumbo, really. They're just telling the Dumbo story in a different sort of way.
There's always beauty in every aspect of a person. And for me, that's what that little story is all about. Acceptance. And finding the very thing that you dislike the most about yourself and realizing it's something to celebrate.
People is painted on, and I'm holding the magic feather, and I...
thing that saves the day someday.
Dumbo is my favorite Disney movie.
To view you. To view an image fully.
In a typical working week, the studio staff consumes 4,000 quartos of animation paper, 40 gross of assorted color crayons, and 49,000 reams of celluloid.
That's so.
And all I left you.
Okay, let's try it again. A little more pressure.
Please.
Hey, look out!
Don't be afraid. I'm only the train whistle.
Well, they certainly have improved the looks of them since I was a boy. What goes on around here?
We're making the sound for a cartoon train. Look, I'll show you.
All aboard! All aboard! Clear the track! Here I go!
Well, does that come natural, or is that something you picked up in high school?
Oh, anybody can do it. The train sounds are all on here. You hold these over your vocal cords and move your lips, like this. Don't you want to try
it? No, I wouldn't know what to say.
Oh, say anything. Only don't really talk. Just make believe.
Oh, I'm tickled now. What do I say? Friends, Romans, countrymen?
Anything.
Friends, Romans, countrymen.
See how easy it is?
Pardon me, Mr. Bensley. This is your score, Doris. I've got all the cues marked in, I think. You come in right after the fourth beat there, okay?
Okay, Frank.
Let's give it a lot of personality now.
All right, ready, everybody.
Casey Jr. I used to know his old man.
All right, boys, let's go for a rehearsal. Lights. Picture.
Let's go. One, two, three, four.
All aboard. All aboard.
Cows.
Ready with your storm? Okay, cut, lights.
I'll be running along.
Thanks ever so much.
How did you like it?
Oh, fine, fine. Only after all, wouldn't it be a lot easier just to wreck a real train?
Walt Disney's Disneyland, the story of Dumbo. Now, here is your host, Walt Disney.
From time to time, people ask me, which is the favorite of all the pictures that we've made? Well, it's the one that you're going to see right now on this program. The story of the little elephant with the big ears, Dumbo. From the very start, Dumbo was a happy picture. It really started from a very simple idea and, like Topsy, just grew. We weren't restricted by any set storyline, so we could give our imaginations full play. In other words, if a good idea came to us, we put it in the story. It was really a happy picture from the very beginning to the end. As our story begins, we discover Mr. Stork on his way to the winter quarters of the circus with a package for a certain Mrs. Jumbo.
Hi. Here's...
Hiya, kids. Remember me? I'm Timothy Mouse.
here to introduce you to the world's greatest elephant in Dumbo's Big Discovery. Hope you have fun reading and playing along.
Dumbo's big ears made him different from other elephants. His mother knew he was special. But the other elephants laughed at him.
Hey, kids, click on the elephants and the animals on the...
Only a mother could love those ears.
Jumbo. He should be called Dumbo.
Look at those ears. Aren't they funny?
We think your ears are cute, Dumbo.
Your mother's right. You are special.
Oh, don't listen to them.
One day, Dumbo and his friend Timothy Mouse...
That's me!
...met a baby kangaroo, who did not laugh at Dumbo's big ears. The little kangaroo showed them his big feet. Then he showed them what his feet could do. The kangaroo asked Dumbo what he could do with his big ears.
Click on the kangaroo to hear what he has to say. And don't forget about the animal.
My big feet are for jumping. What are your big ears for?
I'm a tiger, and I have funny stripes on my fur. They help me hide from other animals.
I'm a giraffe, and I have a really long neck. It helps me find food.
I am a gorilla, and my arms are longer than my legs, so I can swing from tree to tree.
Dumbo remembered that his ears could keep him warm and dry. The little kangaroo felt that Dumbo's ears could do more. And Dumbo discovered that his new friend was right.
Remember to click on the animals on the train to hear what they have to say.
You're the best!
Hooray for Dumbo!
You can do it, Dumbo.
Dumbo learned that his ears could help him fly. No one laughed at Dumbo's ears after that. In fact, everyone agreed that Dumbo was pretty special.
hope you liked our little story. And don't forget, it's what makes you different that makes you most special.
Hi, kids. Welcome. We're...
Experience the all-new adventure of a lifetime as the classic story continues. Join us for a sneak peek behind the scenes of the production of Walt Disney's Dumbo 2. The legacy began when Walt Disney became captivated by the original story of a baby elephant with big ears and an even bigger heart.
It was a little book with about eight illustrations in it with an elephant with big ears. I got it from Walt and said, "See what you can do with this."
It's a great lesson for all of us. Whether we're 2 years old or 70 years old, we all are different, and we ultimately all do belong.
A lot of people have said to me, "Oh, it always makes me cry." I mean, it's quite believable.
The challenge will be in making a sequel that does the same.
We're basically continuing our story as if, like, a day or so after the original.
The kids accidentally get themselves disconnected from the rest of the circus, and they end up in the big city.
They want to have this freedom, but they also have to try to figure out how they're going to get back home.
The storyline and everything, where we're going, it will be all new, but I think it'll have the same flavor and feeling of the old version.
Dumbo 2 is filled with new characters who come to know and love Dumbo, each in their own special way.
This is a story about realizing the importance of friendship, that a friend is always there, looks out for you.
Timothy the Mouse returns.
He was Dumbo's best friend when Dumbo didn't have any friends. Timothy really understands him, and he can voice what Dumbo's feeling.
Plus, wonderful new characters.
When we were developing the project, we were trying to figure out the different stages of development that children go through. These universal truths will kind of resonate when you watch the movie.
There's Claude and Lolly.
Claude and Lolly are a set of twin bears that are in a rush to get everything done. They leave chaos behind them wherever they go.
Dot, a most curious zebra.
She questions everything. Why?
Godfrey, the I can do it all by myself hippo.
Godfrey is a little bit older. He is going through that stage where he wants to be able to do his own thing and not be told what to do.
And Penny, the adventurous ostrich.
She wants to be in the spotlight. She's a bit jealous. Here's Dumbo. He's an elephant. He can fly. She's a bird. She can't fly.
The story is about friendship and parental love, and that there truly is no place like home.
Coming soon from Walt Disney Pictures, Dumbo 2. Premiering on Disney DVD and video.
People with big ears are famous. Oh, boy. All we gotta do is build an act. Make you a star. A headliner. Dumbo the Great.
Walt Disney's Dumbo brings you a trainload of exciting new characters. Wild animals. Ferocious beasts. Thunderous pachyderms. Jungle giants. Casey Jr., the train with a personality. And believe it or not, the most delightful Disney sequence you've ever seen, the Parade of the Pink Elephants. see Dumbo's magnificent fall to fame, the most sensational climax ever filmed.
Look out for Mr. Stork. He's got you on his list. And when he comes around, it's useless to resist. Remember those quintuplets and the woman in the shoe. Maybe he's got his eye on you.
Dumbo, the little elephant who was all ears. Gossips discover the scandalous truth about the new arrival.
Have I got a trunk full of dirt?
His mother goes wild.
Down! Dumbo, down!
Socially, he was washed up. His only friend, a mouse.
You know, lots of people with big ears are famous. Oh, boy. All we gotta do is build an act. Make your star, a headliner, Dumbo the Great!
Walt Disney's Dumbo brings you a trainload of exciting new characters. Wild animals, ferocious beasts, ponderous pachyderms, jungle giants. Casey Jr., the train with a personality. And believe it or not, the most delightful Disney sequence you've ever seen, The Parade of the Pink Elephants. See Dumbo's magnificent fall to fame, the most sensational climax ever filmed.
Whee!
Thank you.
up and get your tickets. Hurry, hurry, hurry.